3 years ago, one historic campaign turned U.S. politics into a pop culture phenomenon.
Yes, we can.
We'll change the world.
The Democratic candidate achieved unprecedented support, international fame, and a record-breaking $650 million in donations. Thousands of New Yorkers celebrated the victory, clutching an enormous American flag hand-sewn by Obama supporters. But the winds have changed, and the very same Democratic symbol waved in honor of the president-elect in 08...
Each stripe, let me show you a stripe.
...has been donated to the movement that became a phenomenon in 2011.
Are there about 20 people holding it?
David Mafuda organized the Flag Project after being inspired by Obama rhetoric, a dream shattered by the subsequent years of politics as usual.
Currently, what's inspiring me is OWS. Like, that's the thing that's inspiring me now. Like, that's why I brought the flag to OWS. And the thing that inspired me about it is the fact that it's a grassroots movement that had a very clear and transparent process.
Artist Shepard Fairey seems similarly disenchanted, releasing an updated version of his iconic Hope poster, replacing Obama with his now clear support for Occupy Wall Street. With an economy still in crisis, Wall Street largely unregulated, social programs slashed, and over 45 million citizens on food stamps.
It all starts with you making a decision to get involved.
Obama's familiar prose may not be enough to win back his familiar fan base.
He didn't produce what people wanted him to produce.
In 2008, professor and author Dr. Cornel West was one of Obama's biggest supporters.
I think he's got the vision, he's got the newness, he's got the freshness.
Taking part in more than 100 campaign events. But last April, the prominent intellectual told RT that Obama has failed.
He's the friendly face of the American empire abroad. He's in the process, actually, of becoming, very sadly, a pawn of big finance and a puppet of big business.
And any politician here knows they're in trouble when the Hollywood A-listers start turning their backs.
Are you happy with the way that Obama has been running the country? You fan?
No.
No?
No, I really think he misinterpreted his mandate.
Yet the approval ratings show voters are even more turned off with the alternatives, leaving Obama seemingly the lesser of two evils. America's president clearly enters the 2012 race amid a growing band of disillusioned Democrats. Most will still back Barack Obama over his Republican rivals, arguably with heavy hearts. In 2008, he was the unassailable candidate of choice. This time, Mr. Obama is likely to stay in by default. Marina Portnaya, RT, New York.